Hi, this is Larry Shover, CIO of SFG Alternatives, reporting to you from the CME Group in Chicago. Well, here we are, the very last trading day of the year, Monday, 12/31. Let's talk about what happened last week to just help build a case for volatility. S&P one-month implied volatility last week was up 3.5 points to 18.3%. The VIX followed in suit, up 4.9 points to 51st percentile in the last 5 years. Commodity vol also rose. Oil one-month volatility rose about 0.75% last week, up to 25.6%. Gold one-month implied volatility rose almost 2%, or 2 points, I'm sorry, to 13%. G7 vol one-month up about 0.75 point to 7.1. Notable, the Japanese yen had the biggest weekly move in a long time last week, stabilizing most of the volatility. Corporate spreads widened quite a bit last week from the 19th to the 37th percentile as judged over the last 5 years. Now, we can say all of these events, what's causing volatility to move up is basically the unknowns of the fiscal cliff, also with corporate spreads widening, just causing a whole cloud of concern over the CME options markets. But what stands out right now? S&P implied volatility, the highest level it's been since June of 2012. The spread between historical vol and implied vol is the highest level, the highest spread it's been all year. Skew over the last 2 weeks in the S&P 500 has gone from the 20th percentile all the way to the 83rd percentile as judged over the last 1 year. And lastly, term structure is at a one-year low right now. Now, when it comes to cross-asset correlation or cross-asset contagion, what is driving volatility right now? Right now, keeping the floor on volatility happens to be gold volatility and the U.S. 10-year Treasury volatility. Keeping the ceiling on volatility right now tends to be sovereign debt and also Eurovol. It's going to be very exciting to see what happens in 2013. Will the fiscal cliff get done by in the next few hours, or is it something that we're going to have to deal with in 2013? Volatility is giving us a much different signal than most of us would have believed even 2 weeks ago. I'm Larry Shover, CIO of SFG Alternatives, reporting to you from the CME Group in Chicago.